I know our favorite superhero usually hangs out at the local phone booth, but here at the House of Fantasy in Niagara Falls, you can find Superman, Batman, Spider-Man, all of those great crime fighters.
I've been collecting comic books since before I was able to read. I really think that comic books taught me how to read.
What began as a childhood hobby 25 years ago has now grown into a full-time occupation for Paul Benny. Now, instead of just collecting comic books, he sells them. Old ones, new ones, for a couple of bucks or a couple of hundred. How many comic books do you have?
A bunch.
They're everything that every kid wants to be but can't be. Super powerful, able to leap tall buildings at a single bound, bend steel in your bare hands, that sort of thing. They're fun. They're like Star Wars. Only you can reread them and they're not as expensive.
Paul says comic books are not just kid stuff anymore.
There are people who buy comic books because they've appreciated more in the last 10 years than gold, silver, coins, stamps, any of that stuff.
Comic books are just make-believe. People don't act like that in real life, do they? Gee, Paul, this looks like an interesting comic book. How much does this one sell for?
Give me that, you fool. That's a $200 comic book.
Zowie, $200? That's a lot of money.
It's not the most expensive comic book there is, though. An Action Number One in mint condition goes over $14,000.
Holy retirement fund. Paul's first love is actually drawing cartoons himself, and although he hasn't gotten his big break yet, he's keeping his fingers crossed.
I think that's what I'd really like to do almost more than anything, is to be a real comic book artist. Mm-hmm. Primarily I like superheroes, fantasy, sword and sorcery, that sort of thing.
Take it easy, Paul. See you later. A visit to Paul Benny's shop made me feel
more powerful than a locomotive, faster than a speeding bullet, able to leap tall.
Mike Randall, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.